when I was interviewing, I was struck when I came to the NIH that a lot of the people I talked to, a lot of the investigators, were actually still working at the bench. So the only place I interviewed in the whole country where I would go into someone's lab and they weren't in the office sitting at the computer, they were at the bench. They had gloves on, they were pipetting, and I came in and they said, "Great, let me finish this reaction and we have 15 minutes and I'll come right back and then we can keep talking." And that really impressed me. I think, you know, I really wanted to stay involved and at the bench and keep working and actually doing the science. My name is Keir Neuman. I'm a tenure track investigator in Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute. And we're in Building 50. We're in our experimental room. So this is a room where we do our most sensitive measurements and where we built these sort of custom measurement tools. Behind me is the magnetic tweezers. So this is a device that allows us to manipulate single molecules of DNA. We can both pull on them and twist them. And it's very similar to this hose. So one end of this goes down on a microscope slide. The other end we attach to a micron-sized magnetic particle. And there's small magnets, which are right in here. These are where the magnets are held. And they basically apply a small force up on the bead that's attached to the DNA. And so by pulling, by increasing the magnetic field, I can stretch the DNA or I can relax it. And I can also, importantly, by rotating the magnets, I can twist up the DNA. And that's exactly, almost exactly like a hose. And so you can see after some amount of twisting, I create, these are called plectonemes, when the DNA forms a superhelix around itself. And what you can see is that my hands have come closer together when I form the plectonemes. Exactly what's happening in the magnetic tweezers. So as I wind up the bead, it comes closer and closer to the surface. And by measuring the position of the bead along the optical axis, or in the height of the bead, if you will, I can determine the topology of the DNA. So what we're doing, the general technique that we apply in all of these instruments is something called single molecule biophysics. And so what we're doing is we're trying to investigate the biochemistry or the enzymatic cycle, or what do individual enzymes do. The biological systems we can measure with this are anything that interacts with DNA. So it changes either the mechanics of DNA. So if an enzyme were to bind and, for example, loop a piece of DNA, I can see that because the extension decreases. Or a large class of enzymes we study are the so-called the topoisomerases that can unknot and unlink DNA. And so we wind up the DNA and it unknots it or unlinks it, and we can follow that. Again, we can follow individual steps of individual enzymes.